Hi, I'm Garrett Mundelein with Treadlight Renewable Resources. Welcome to 563 County Road, and I'm going to go through some of the features of the building for you. We'll start off, the building has a solar array on top. We have a Fronius inverter down here that has the capability of being hooked into internet so that you can regulate it from your computer, from your iPhone or from your iPad. It'll tell you how much energy is being generated each day, each week, each year, how much carbon dioxide you're offsetting, and how much money you're saving from Excel. Currently, the utilities on the building for this past month were $16, and that's the base amount that Excel charges, so you can't get your bill any less than that. And we're putting a lot of electricity into the grid, and we have a 2.5 kilowatt array on top of the unit that services just this side. And then the adjacent unit has its own array that services its own side. The garage itself is insulated with insulated concrete forms, and so it's we specifically use box block on this building, and they're 6-inch concrete forms. They're 10 times stronger than a conventional foundation. They'll withstand 210 mile an hour winds. And they also create a thermal mass for us. So we have those tied into 19 caissons around the base of the building that are 2-foot diameter caissons, go 14 feet into the ground. And they create a 55 degree thermal mass that ties in through the common wall and goes all the way up to the roof line. And that helps the building to try to maintain a 55 degree temperature. So it reduces our cooling costs in the summer and decreases our heating costs in the winter. In addition, our garage door has an R21 insulation value, which is significantly higher than a lot of other homes have even in their walls. So we are super insulated. So in here we have a triangle tube point of use boiler. And so this gives us, it's 150,000 BTU unit. It supplies all the heat necessary for both our domestic hot water and our heating services. We have hot water that goes from this to an air handler, heats up the air handler, and then that will heat up the house. One of the benefits of that is in a conventional forced air heating system, you will have your air going across an open flame, and that open flame will burn oxygen, just reduce the air quality in general, and it adds chemicals into the air that you're breathing. This system is keeping the flame isolated from your air that you're going to be breathing, and it just heats the water and then allows the water to heat the air. So your air quality in a building is going to be significantly higher with this unit. It's also a 96% efficient build unit, which means for every dollar you spend on gas, you're getting 96 cents worth of heat, whereas a lot of units are running at about 80% efficient. Behind me is the manifold. So this manifold gives us all of our water supply for the entire house, all the fixtures. It's tied directly into our service from the city. Our service from the city is 60 psi. This manifold will maintain that pressure to every single fixture in the house. So the way we've set this up, you will never get a drop in your pressure to any fixture. Each fixture is hardwired directly to this. So even if you turn every fixture on in the house, you will have 60 PSI at all times on. And that's it for this room. So we'll go upstairs and check out what we have.
So our main entrance, we have elk decking, which is a composite of number 2, number 5, and wood fiber. And it has an extremely long lifespan. It has reduced fading capacity compared to some of the other composite materials that are on the market. All of our siding is concrete and all of our trim work is concrete. So these are hardy trim and hardy board for our siding. We painted the siding in a factory down in Denver, which gave us the ability to heat it while it was being painted. So it changed it from your typical 5 to 7 year lifespan to a 20 year lifespan and just embeds the paint in. Much better just for general better looks. Same with the trim, it's embedded in, it's heated in, so it gives us a nice time period for the longevity of the mat. The siding and the exterior portions of the house are rated to 160 miles an hour before we start having cosmetic damage. So most buildings have about 120 mile an hour engineering load, where at 110 to 120 mile an hour you start getting structural damage. you'll have cosmetic damage occurring at 60 to 80 mile an hour. This building will not have cosmetic damage until 160, and the structure is rated up to 210 mile an hour winds. Our railings are recycled aluminum. It is aircraft grade aluminum. It's powder coated, so once again we have a long lifespan for the color, and it's a very rigid material. Welcome to the main level, second floor of the building. So on this level we have the whole main level is solid oak, 3/4 inch oak that is powder coated in a factory. A couple benefits that we have from that is by finishing the material in the factory, it's more of a controlled environment. You get a harder coat material that lasts longer. Using the solid 3/4 inch material gives us the ability to extend the life of the floor. So if it does get scratched up over time, you can sand it 4, 5, 6 times before you have to replace it. And so from a green standpoint, that seems to make more sense to us. We prefer to use oak, even though it tends to come from trees that take a lot longer to grow as opposed to bamboo, because oak is available here in Colorado as opposed to shipping something in from Indonesia. So that gives us our green approval for the oak floors. The carpets that we have from on the stair units and going through to upstairs are number 2 and number 5 recycled plastic bottles. This gives them a high stain resistance and a very good resilience. So it is a commercial rated carpet, and we've installed them in our houses for about 7 years. Several of our homes that we use as rentals, the carpet still looks brand new. So once again, it gives you a good green standpoint in the longevity. They are solid wood cabinets. These are maple cabinets. We have features such as the soft glide, where the drawers won't slam, they pull themselves closed. Schrock is a very high quality wood cabinet. The practices that they use for painting and staining their cabinetry correlates with California regulations, which is much more restrictive than other areas in the country. And so they're limiting what they're putting into our atmosphere as they do their finishes. And that's one of the reasons why we use Schrock. We have granite countertops. Once again, the longevity issue. So the granite most likely will never have to be replaced. And so we're always looking for things as to what their lifespan is, where they come from, and what their energy stamp is. And that's how we pick and choose what we're putting in the house. Everything that was used in the entire structure of the house is low VOC formaldehyde free. So from the glues that we use to build the structure, to the paints that we use to paint the structure, they all are low emission chemicals that we use. So the house, if you were here, you would notice that it does not have a new home smell. That new home smell is actually carcinogens that are in the air. And so it's not a good thing. And this shows that it's not off-gassing, because you don't smell that it's a new home. So another feature that we have in here is the bank of windows. It helps bring in a lot of natural light, so it'll eliminate a lot of turning the lights on and off during the day. Usually when we've been in this space even working, we don't even have the lights on because it's bright enough with just the natural lighting. So we're in the master bedroom of 563 County Road now. The main feature that you would see up here is the roof line. So with the roof line, we use a panel system called SIPS panels. We get ours from R Control, which are located here in Denver. So once again, we have close proximity to the construction site, so we're not off-gassing a lot and shipping materials across the country to us. SIPS panels in this case are 10 inches thick. They qualify as a high insulative material. For the insulation value in a conventional home, you're right around R32. These exceed R50, and not only do they have a real value of R50, but because of the way they attach and seal, they create an effective value that's much higher. You stop losing heat at about R40 in your insulation values. The walls throughout the building, from the bottom of the main level up to the roof line, is all conventionally framed structure, but we have a soy-based spray foam insulation in the framing materials. And once again, that gives us an excess of R40 for our walls, and it gives a complete seal, which allows or prevents any air penetration coming in and out. So it increases the effective R value of the material as well. The other benefit that we have from the SIPS panels is there's no attic space. Since the panel itself is insulative, we can create these vaulted ceilings throughout the second floor. So every room, whether it be bathroom or bedroom or closet, throughout the second floor or third floor, the bedroom level, has vaulted ceilings, and it just adds to the openness of the room. And I think that's everything for this building.